Alright, this looks rather final. Look how many there are. Get to push some of them away just to read. In dreams, there is hope. What, the hope that we're already dead? Well, this looks dramatic. There's something tall over here. Can't make out what it is. There's these weird things. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 wooden structures, 8 sausages. Oh, right, because the moment I start, they're all going to sink. Well, that gives us a clear starting task. This will probably be a slightly repetitive challenge for this beginning part. Gonna ferry them all in one by one. Bring out your dead! Now that we know that they're all corpses of some kind, it kind of makes the whole thing creepier. It's like I'm putting each of them in a... You almost want to say I'm putting them in a coffin, but I'm making them all stick out halfway, which is creepier. I don't even get to bury them all one by one. They'll get to awkwardly stick in there. There we go. It's oddly like delivering mail, but the mail is meat sausages. And the path you take crosses these tulips. Tulips, maybe? I don't know. They're all vertical rectangle flowers. God pillar. Well, there's a rather dramatic name. So now that the sausages were placed, they're all... That's a ladder. That's important. That's really important. Okay. Also annoying when I do my rotational movement thing. So I must this must make a ladder that I can use to get across? I wonder if this has a genuine puzzle to it, or if it's just a very simple, like, put them over there and win situation. I mean, I'm sure the first one's the easiest one to place. So my goal is to get up there. Probably want to grill them all along the way, too. Including that one. Just bring you along. Alright, you're grilled. I should probably start with closer ones, because stuff's going to get in the way a little bit otherwise. Damn it. Alright, so here's the fun question is, how do I proceed from here? Like, if I climb a ladder while it's on my fork, something will probably... Like, I could lift it up. Let's try bringing these two together. Maybe not that quite far. That would have to be at kind of a weird angle to do that, huh? Like, more like over... more like up and down. Ah! Goddamn ladders. Alright, so... If I were to climb this ladder, it would have to be... one over here. Then one closer. And now I should be able to... Nope. One more. Should be able to climb the ladder while having the fork in. Unless that's not a ladder over there. There's no ladder over there. Can't really see it. Okay, so are the ladders only on the fronts? Fine, I can work around that. Just need to put the hole right there. Cool. What do I do with that, though? Oh, this one's gonna get weird fast. We push it back to the origin point. Let's try to line it up with the fork. Like that. Here's my spot. It's on me now. If I move sideways, we drop it. So if I move backwards, it'll be on the platform. What if I go under it again? Oh. A little more stuck than I was hoping, honestly. Oh, there's gaps. Oh! Turning made it stick out. Interesting. Although now I'm kind of... That's bad. Probably don't want that to happen. How do I make that not happen, though? Aha! Doesn't help either. Things are a little lopsided at the moment. Nothing to worry about. Do not concern yourself with this. Those audio problems are actually starting to bother me. I might take my headphones off just to not listen to the, just to not hear the game anymore. That'd make me really feel weird in the silence here, but it might give me a headache. At least for you guys, the audio is compressed because I do audio editing, but for me, the audio sounds bad every time that happens. It's just a spike of volume in my head. Let's see. Can't really tell what's going on in here very well. Ah, this seems like a lopsided mess that's going to get me in trouble. Aha! Now I'm stuck. Ooh. Could this be my one and only chance to get things lined up again? No, not really. What if I went inside of it? It's almost helpful. Everything's now all lined up in the wrong position. There we go. So now I can auto-climb just fine. But there's more space to the wall. Did not come off my head. Right. I gave myself one more extra space, so now it doesn't come off my head till I go that far in. Which means I can escape. Okay. Whew. So just keep moving the whole thing out each time by one, I hope, is enough. I hope, sincerely. There's just enough steps in my solution that I'm not entirely sure if I can recreate them every time. I mean, I'm sure by the time we get to 8, I'll have a pretty good idea of what I'm doing. But right now, I'm slightly stumbling still. So did I do it again correctly? Up against the wall. We've escaped. Yes, okay. So just keep doing this. Keep pushing it out by 1. Oops. 1. Exactly 1. Give me your sweet success. Victory is so at hand. I just gotta do one task over and over again for a bit. Maybe there's supposed to be something vaguely biblical about the repeated action or something. I don't know. I don't know, man. Don't ask me. Oops, don't do that. Sure is getting taller. Needs to be right here. Centered. It's kind of adorable. He makes the little chimp noise every single time. I forgot to give myself space this time. Dummy. I want to rewind it. There we go. Ow. That hurt my ears. So I compress my audio, which means that the volume usually stays relatively standard. So it might not be apparent to you guys, but for me, while I'm playing this game, every now and then I'll just do any action, and that one action will be like 500% louder than every other sound. And it doesn't really make it's really odd for that kind of thing to be happening. It seems to be an audio bug. It's hard to tell if it's the game or if my computer or something. I hope it's not my computer, because computer was relatively new. Although it could be a driver problem, I suppose. It's just something that I say as someone who knows very little about computers, honestly. Is this the last one? One more. I lost count of what of how much progress I had made, so suddenly I was like, wait, am I about to be over already? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. One more to go. Definitely one of those repetition puzzles. I feel like, wasn't the tower like this a little bit too? The tower might have been foreshadowing at this point. I probably forgot to push it out again. Right, I need to not push you as far then if I do that. Up we go! Wow, it's dramatic. Even the light changes in hue and everything. There is nothing up there. It's just... Why did I do that? I went one stage too far. I guess I was really focused on the background and what I was reaching, which seems to be nothing. Which is all the more concerning. I am at the top! I did it! Well, this sure seems like the end of the game, because it's just a top. Like, it just ends up there. The only logical thing is that it probably... I probably need to grill everything next. To proceed. Let's try to make this as satisfying as possible, so I'll take all the ungrilled things and try to put them in a row. Just for the full majesty of it all. This one's gonna have to get out of the way. Made the mistake of grilling him early, and I'm not about to restart the entire puzzle to feel better about it, so... Just put him on the bottom to be caught by the others as they have their triumphant parade of triumph. You will be the first. There we go. Everyone get in line. Actually, it might work out perfectly, where the exact number I have left over is how many I need to fit. And that one, the one that's facing the direction, almost be like the guy that fires the button for us to start the race. Fires the button? What? Gun. Oh yeah, I could just push you guys all in, too. Ta-da! Alright. And he fires it off, and he says, go! Oops. And then this happens. Really? Why, game? Why am I made to suffer? Just had to make them not quite fit, huh? Oh, right, there's one of them over here. Oops. There's so many of them. Oh, all the holes fill back in. What do I do with that? Ow, ow, ow. Didn't pay attention to that. Oh, a grill is still active in the overworld. That's why it caught me off guard. There's never a grill in the overworld. I think I'm just supposed to push it down to the grill. All their dreams unburdened now, it's time for the world to wake. 215. Go! I'm slightly off. I'm gonna go die now. Well, that was Well, that was shameful. Try pushing you off this way a little bit. Here we go. Grill! Now what do? I have failed. So I guess I'm not supposed to stand on it. Which makes me wonder how I knock it off in the first place. Maybe over here. Doesn't really fix the problem, does it? I might be getting a little tired now from doing so many puzzles. I don't know if I can keep going. How do I get it down? So going by its starting position, it seems like I don't want me to stand on it. Oh, right. This whole pillar is ladders. That's the whole reason there's two ladders. Level design! There's always an answer in the level design. It's always some element of like, why is there that thing there? Why is there two ladders? Why is there a weird outcrop over there? And every single time, it's always because it's the solution for the puzzle. Every single time. Oh, weird, there's one random hole over here. Odd. It's grilled. Ta-da! So now what? I mean, that's it. That's the sausage. Oh, what if I have to take it to the beginning of the game or something? All this time, the world has been a level in its own right. Oh my god, they turned all the grills back on. So now I have to dodge grills for the rest of the game? I mean, I don't have a ton of reason to think that I need to take it with me. It's already grilled. So I win? I'll try going back to the beginning anyway. This will be a fun moment for us to review the oldest game I've played. Dear lord. This'll cement just how much stuff has happened over the course of the game, huh? Oh wait, I can go under this. It's not a solid cliff. It just looks like one because, you know, everywhere else in the game there's one. That's the weird floaty spot. We've been through so much today. And every day. So I made it. I think I made it, if this is the end of the game. I was talking about the idea of finishing in one sitting, but whether or not my brain could take it. It seems to have taken it. But I'm a little low on input right now. We finished the thing over there. So the question is what I'm supposed to do, because there's usually a credits roll or there's some kind of definitive ending. It'd be a really kind of depressing anti-climax if the game just ran out of puzzles all of a sudden, and then it's like no more game. No game ever ends that way. That would be cruel to have a game end without making it clear that it was in fact over. No one would do that to their own audience, would they? I am stuck here, aren't I? This damn spot. I hate you, ladders. I hate you, ladders. Okay, I'm not even joking right now. How do I get out of here? Ladders, you are a constant source of anxiety. Right, this one over here. God damn it. Alright, fine. My brain just gets shut down by ladders, even when the solution's kind of simple. It's just like, but just let me move normally. I just want to move. Damn it. I understand it's part of the puzzle. Obviously, this whole game is puzzles, so every mechanic is part of the puzzle. But there's something innately frustrating about having your basic controls ripped away from you of how you normally control your character. Just because I play a lot of video games, and as a general rule, your ability to walk around is something you get to keep most of the time. It might even be part of the slight frustration that happens when you play a game like Gears of War, and you, the game decides, it's time for story, so Marcus puts his finger up to his ear and starts talking to somebody on the radio, and you lose the ability to jump or climb over things or anything, and you just have to sit there and walk very slowly in a direction while the game has story happen, and you can't play, but you're still technically playing. Like, that's like the weird in-between thing where it's like, you can still walk around, but you can't really do anything for a while. That weird limitation is oddly frustrating, but it's slighter in that case. But in this game's case, you lose all ability to walk around, and suddenly you're like, no, I just wanna. It's obviously a minor thing. It's not even like a real complaint, it's just the emotional response to a mechanic that exists for very clear reasons, because it's part of every puzzle. But every single time I'm just like, ah! Hey, look, there's the starting point. Did I get all of them? I mean, something's clearly changed because suddenly every single grill is on in the entire maze. You can see them on everywhere. They weren't on before. That's a big deal. That's the one core difference in what I've accomplished here, is that suddenly, almost creepily, all of the human furnace things that were presumably used to cook humans, because this game's creepy, are suddenly all activated at once. Here we go, we're at the beginning of the linear area. That was a real time changer when that first happened. This is the one. I think it was called The End or something? It was the first puzzle that I solved, where suddenly I was ripping something clean out of the ground, and we were introducing the insane concept that I was going to be able to move around objects with my sausages, and that they're weirdly weightless and could be lifted up like that. And here's the big final meadow, which is the last big chunk of the non-linear part of the game that was still... It was relatively tough. That's kind of a pointless thing to say. This whole goddamn game was tough. Oh. You're not cooked. Were there any other ones back here? I'll double check whatever got me to the previous level. Logically, you would assume, like, we're cooking things to proceed, so if there's... I just want to check Oh, Jesus Christ, how do I navigate this level again? Can't go that way. I don't remember the end. The end didn't have an uncooked sausage in it, did it? I think I have to go the long way around up here. So I think I need to go back and cook all of the level transition sausages. I'm just double checking to see if this one didn't have one. I think I solved this puzzle and then this thing opened up and let me through. I don't see anything uncooked around here. Okay, so. I'm already set to continue then. But yeah, the level transition sausages we unlocked, they're not cooked. And it was impossible to cook them before, because the in-level grills, the overworld grills, would always be turned off. But this guy is not ready. That's not gonna work. I have to move you around manually. Oh, and it's gonna be, like, weirdly hard to cook it, isn't it? No, just push it over there. Oh. Maybe a little hard. I'll just use this spot. Gotcha. So now that one's cooked. How many more are there? 215 is our current total. There should only be one per zone, I think. Oh no, I think there was two in some of them. So this is the next zone. At least we know there's zone transitions, so if it's before the zone transition, we're not there yet. Oh, that guy. Now there's a way better spot up there. Hang on a second. Just get off this. I can just use the guy right over here. Success! Just gotta find my way out of snow now. Was the snow right after the tower? It feels so short when you're running past it in reverse, obviously. Especially since we don't even have to run past the puzzles themselves, we just have to run around wherever we feel like it. Let's see, was this meadow over here the tower? Oh yeah. The Great Tower. The first what-the-fuck puzzle of the meadow. So I need to find a spot to cook you, and that'll be easy, right down here. So I just need to get behind you, so I can push you down. Is there space back here to do that? I can't really see. Yeah. Cooked. Okay. Am I near the beginning? I'm gonna have to go right, I think. Right, this was level 2, basically. I did the whole first area to finally unlock the way to go past the first area. And then I got here. I think that might be the first sausage right there. The primordial sausage. Don't walk on it. Stop trying to walk on it. How do... Probably push it down. Oh yeah, I specifically remember this thing as being the first end of level message. Push you down like that. That's probably right, yeah, because then I have access to this spot. To push it back down. Now we just need to find any uncovered grill spot. That's a good one. Just any of the ones that are easy to access. So just to clarify what made me think that we were going to get out of here, why I was thinking that this is our exit, is look down here. We looked across the bay a moment ago. In the sand, there's the puzzle symbol. This is where we started the whole game, but you can see the puzzle symbol there. I saw that when we were ending the linear area, and it lets you oversee the shipwreck, and you can see the puzzle symbol in the distance. That's noteworthy because every single puzzle has disappeared. This whole area used to be puzzles, and you can't see the symbol anywhere. But now... Yep, I was right. Cool. So is it a new... Is it a final puzzle or an ending? That was my shipwreck from the beginning. Well, this is nostalgic. Well, now I am Sausage Puzzle. So all those other ones may have also been other people who solved everything, and then... Oh, wow, yeah, they were talking about the concept of, like, being the last person left and everything like that. Like who takes care of the last sausage? So now I've solved everything, and then I turn into the last sausage, and then I guess I just sit there. Forever. Woo! It's a puzzle game. Story is kind of, like, a weird... The story only really matters in the context of, like, it can mess with you and have, like, be like, boom, weird reveal. But really the point is to solve all the puzzles. And that was a sufficiently climactic puzzle with a giant tower and going back through previous levels and everything. That was an experience. This has been Steven Sausage Roll, the latest puzzle game on this channel. If you enjoyed the series and haven't already checked them, I strongly recommend going back and watching my shows I did for The Talos Principle and The Witness. Those are the two really good ones that I've done in the past. There's a few other ones I've done. I've done a few puzzle games like Chroma Gun and stuff like that, but those are really the two that really stand out as being the great ones. I believe I have a whole puzzle category on the front page, unless you're watching this in some distant future where I've changed the layout of how I handle my front page of my channel or something. But yeah, very difficult and intensely innovative puzzle game here. Not heavy on story, not heavy on visuals, so like I never got lost in the world the way I did in The Witness, with the environment, obviously, because there kind of wasn't much of an environment. I think I'd say it's not my favorite type of puzzle game, in that I think I like... My favorite type of puzzle game is probably the portal type of game. Here's a chamber, and you move these objects around and make them interact in special ways, and that feeling, that kind of first person move around in an environment and move things around, I'm probably a little more comfortable with that than this grid-based Sokoban thing that we had here, but I can't help but still fully appreciate how incredibly clever this game was, because pretty much every damn puzzle had something new to throw at you, and you were still just using the most basic mechanics of walking around in four different directions, but little twists which the game didn't teach you. freesound.org/people/the-semen-incident is one of those sound effects. What? That's apparently how they got the water sound. That was distracting. Just to see pop up. Yeah, the rigid movement's a little frustrating. It's just part of the genre, but it gets to me at sometimes. But yeah, neat game. Anything that constantly innovates and doesn't waste your time and constantly has new ideas to show you for its entire thing always feels like a really good package, and this game accomplished that. It's very much a worthy successor, or not successor is the wrong word to use, but it's very much a game that deserves to be on a shelf next to games like Portal, The Witness, and Talos Principle. Wow, that was weirdly perfectly timed. Well, anyway, guys, this has been Steven's Sausage Roll. My brain's frayed at the moment, and frayed and fried, or both, or something, from doing all that. So, thanks for watching, like always, and I will see you next time.